Welcome to the 1986 college football season on ABC, the University of Nebraska campus where it's pouring rain. The Cornhuskers tonight host the Florida State Seminoles. The Nebraska football team again considered one of the top 10 teams in the country. Florida State may very well deserve top 10 consideration themselves. The 144th consecutive sellout for a Cornhusker home game. Once again, Memorial Stadium at kickoff, the third largest community in the state of Nebraska. ABC Sports presents... CFA Football. The Florida State Seminoles and the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Nebraska has lost running back Doug DuBose, a Heisman candidate, to a season-ending injury, which thrust sophomore quarterback Steve Taylor to the fore as a principal offensive figure for the Cornhuskers. Another sophomore quarterback, Chip Ferguson, becomes the key man for the Florida State Seminoles. Good passer, good field leader, trigger man for the freewheeling Seminoles. A year and a week ago, we were here in this very place for a Saturday afternoon game. The temperature was 103 and the field temperature 135, but you can see what it is tonight. It's downright wintry, and we are fearful that the rain may continue through most of our game tonight, and it certainly may well have an impact on what happens down on the field, because I don't care if you are on artificial surface, it makes it more hazardous in handling the football and sometimes in throwing the football. And now the Seminoles are ready. Here comes Florida State into the stadium. Florida State Seminoles have played a ball game already this year. They defeated Toledo by a score of 24-0, had another fine season last year, and Bobby Bowden, the head man in his 11th year there, one of the top coaching records in the country. And now the roar starts to build for guess who? The Big Red of Nebraska. And it's an incredible stat that they have sold out this stadium 144 successive times. And this man, Tom Osborne, in his 14th season, one of the top records in all of college football, ranked third among the active coaches with a winning percentage. And you can see the Huskers look like they are jacked up for the opener, because they remember well losing 17-13 here a year ago when Florida State held them scoreless in the second half on that hot afternoon. And they know well, too, that if they get out of the blocks against Florida State, the rankings might well go up. The crowd feels as much relief as the football team, having been able
here
to get
Lincoln,
over this
in this stadium.
And tonight's ball game at ABC Sports Exclusive will knock it deep for Keith Ross and Darrell Holloman. Kicking from the 35-yard line, it comes down to Holloman. The junior from Tallahassee has got a hole up the middle. He comes out to the 25, and that's where the Seminoles will go to work with this offensive alignment. And the young man, Chip Ferguson, at quarterback, figures to be very important, particularly on a wet, cool night. Chip Ferguson is a sophomore, but he is a very good field general with a multi-offense to work from. So let's see what happens as Chip comes out looking for his third consecutive win, I guess it is, a fourth consecutive win as a starting quarterback. He stepped in when Danny McManus was injured a year ago and did a fine job for Bobby Bowden Seminole. From the 26-yard line, carrying the ball is Victor Floyd at 6'1", 195, a sophomore out of Pensacola, is brought down by the middle guard, Danny Noonan. Danny Noonan and Chris Buckman are two potential All-Americans. The All-Americans last year, in some people's opinion, and Timmy, they are two horses on the defensive front.
Keith, they really are. Spockman and Noonan. Now, if they occupy three offensive linemen, if it takes three offensive linemen for Florida State to block them, then the advantage, obviously, right away, would go to Nebraska.
Ball is given away. The man carrying the ball is Dane Williams. He bounces outside and
Charlotte McBride.
They say from that knee surgery that Munford lost a step. You couldn't tell on that play because one thing he has is experience. No false steps, goes immediately to the football.
Third down after a loss of two. Third down and 12. And into the middle goes Victor Floyd again. And Floyd pops it out of there. The ball pops away from him. It's still rolling around and is finally covered by Florida State. Mark Selva, the right guard, got upfield chasing that elusive wet pigskin, and he brought it down in Florida State. First threat of the ball game. And Ferguson drops on second down. He goes down the middle with it. Floyd is there. He's got a touchdown. Florida State.
Ferguson, number 27.
A post pattern with the tailback will do the kicking. Keith Jones normally would be the man returning the kicks, but he's got to be the eye back because of the injury to Doug DuBose. The kick falls at the 9-yard line, taken by Vaughn Shepard. And Shepard out of St. Paul, Minnesota, with a good, strong run back, comes outside the 30 to the 33. This is the way the Huskers line up. And we noted that Jones has got to be the eye back with DuBose gone. He'll be very important. But it is the young man at quarterback, Steve Taylor, a sophomore out of the San Diego area in California, that has to pull the trigger for this Nebraska team.
And you can bet the ranch on it that Florida State is going to try to get in his face quickly. You may see some stunts and blitzes. They're going to mix up their coverages and try to confuse him.
He's got it. Taylor turns around the corner and heads up the sidelines for the first down as he goes to the 48-yard line, and that's exactly what Bobby Bowden was talking about when he said he was worried to death over it. The defensive alignment for the Florida State and those inside linebackers, Jones and McGowan, will be a key, I think, for the Seminoles, don't you?
Absolutely. You know, the coaches told the middle guard, Thomas Harp, if he doesn't make a play all day, don't worry about it. Just occupy the blockers so McGowan and Jones can get in the pursuit lanes and make the hits.
Dana Brinson comes in at a wingback spot now. Sophomore from Valdosta, Georgia. Turned upfield too soon, but he got away with it. The handoff goes to the high back Keith Jones, who's in there at about 195 pounds. As the rain for the moment appears to have stopped, ball goes to Keith Jones. Slips away from one tackler, gets down to about the 45. And the young man working the sideline of it. Third down and two. Ball just inside the 45. Steve Taylor with the ball. Got his helmet about the marker, but I think the ball is going to come up a half a yard short as Paul McGowan, one of those inside
down
backers,
Nebraska's going for it.
They're gambling. The ball is out at the 42-yard line. They go inside. Jones, second effort, just barely gets the first down. That is a gamble. Kalen, the fullback, has it. Big Ken Kalen hammers his way to about the 36. Keith Jones, he's the CI back. He's number six. And in motion comes Vaughn Shepard. And Taylor's looking for the pass. Gets it off. Pass is caught by Stitzler. Jason Gamble it is. Jason Gamble had come in at the wide receiver spot, split in. He may have fumbled. He did. Florida State's got it. So on the hit, Gamble lost control of the football.
Pass was completed to Gamble. Jason coughed it up on the hit. And now Chip Ferguson sets him from the 23.
Stands up. Quick pop pass. Good. Caught by Herb Gaynor. And the junior from Sarasota, Huskers hurt themselves with the turnover. First down, just over the 36. Ferguson hands the ball off. Goes to Dane Williams, a big sophomore out of Fruitland Park, Florida. Ferguson, quick two-stepper, pops it again to Gaynor. Gaynor shakes one, and then takes a heck of a lick up around the 4-yard. Floyd and Williams are set wide. Going to throw it again. This time, Gaynor missed connection. He had him.
He was a 6-yard punt by Lewis Berry. Leaves Nebraska first down at their own 29-yard line.
And now the Huskers will have their huddle, and they'll go to work with 7 minutes and 43 seconds remaining to play in this first period. They're playing all of their players tonight. Next Tuesday will be a decision on what kind of a penalty will be assessed against the Huskers. How many players might have to sit down because of the infraction on admissions to the game, the complimentary admission. The handoff goes to the I-back Keith Jones. Jones up to about the 31. Earlier today, I was visiting with Tom Osborne, and into the conversation came the question as to whether or not controlling those admissions is an enforceable rule. Most coaches say no.
Well, it's difficult, and the NCAA investigators, when they first came in, said it was an unenforceable. They said, don't worry about it. Now we got something to worry about. But we think the penalty is a little bit excessive, and What I'd like to see happen, Keith, would be to have the players find some passes, which here in Lincoln, Nebraska is a big deal, because you can't even get your folks into a game if you don't have a pass. You can't buy a ticket. And the other thing I'd like to see maybe be some community service work. You know, kids will listen in the area of drug education, fifth, sixth graders, seventh, eighth graders. When our kids go into the school, they'll listen. I'd like to take a couple days off practice and maybe do some kind of work like that. I think that'd be appropriate. But to take eligibility away, I think, is too harsh in this case.
Going in motion this time is Brinson, the wingback, turns it upfield. Down the line comes Taylor, but the ball is given away to the fullback. Kalen is showing, and Kalen, as Taylor fakes it, is going to go down the line with it. But number 79, big Gerald Nichols, who is one of the fine defensive tackles in the country, 206. It is third down now, and call it two. Taylor coming on the option, turns upfield, gets just enough leverage to pick up the first down.
But if he doesn't throw, the defense can surround you. Load up.
Just inside the 42, first down for the Huskers. Back to the straight eye formation now. Stitzler is wide. Taylor stands up, wings it over there. Pass is thrown to Shepard. Shepard is grabbed just short of the line.
The way you're going to prepare now for what lies ahead, you've got a lot of work to get that knee back in shape, and now your professional chances may be hurt.
Oh, well, I think it's going to make me work a little bit
harder.
Thank
you, Al. First down. For Nebraska at the Florida State 29, as the quarterback Steve Taylor picked it. That'll get a flag. Ken Kalen lost his concentration and broke the play. This is a no counter. Won't count. Pass was caught by Ray Nelson in the end zone, but everybody in the stadium saw Ken Kalen back to the 32 soon, and it'll back to the power eye. Taylor still got it. Turns upfield. He's excited. Down to about the 27-yard line, and he took a lick, and he's slow to get up, but he's first down. Taylor. Taylor back gives to Jones. Jones is grabbed right at the line of scrimmage. And Thomas Harp, Bob Stitzler, and Ron Shepard are the wide people now for the Huskers. They're strong right. Jones looked like he wanted a blitz, but the long count got him outside. Jones hit behind the line.
Field goal as they move the tee up a yard. Cleet Bakeman will do the holding. He is a quarterback. The snap is good. The hold is good. The kick is up.
And he couldn't squeeze enough distance out of it from 49 yards. It is just short and slightly to the right, perhaps. Lloyd and Williams are the split backs for the Seminoles, and Chip Ferguson, the quarterback, to throw it. He goes to the sideline. The pass is caught. Was it caught? No. Ferguson is now 4 out of 6 on his passing. Second down and 10. Ball is given away to Victor Floyd. Finds some daylight over the left side of the line.
Ball is
out near the 37. Ferguson back, a quick drop, looks around. Now he puts it away to the sidelines, and the pass is incomplete. Thrown out of bounds. Herb Gainer was over the line of scrimmage. And Redshirt's up there. They're going after Berry. Good protection for Lewis. Gets the kick away. And Redson makes a mistake. I think he lets the ball bounce. He picked it up and took off. And he is picked off at about the 22-yard line. Kalen and Jones lined up behind Steve Taylor. No, it is not Jones. At Memorial Stadium in Lincoln, the Cornhuskers have the football. Third down, a yard and a half. Florida State sets up a 5-man defensive front. Third down and a yard and a half. And keeping it is Taylor, flips it out now to Kelly, and John Kelly. It's
John
short.
Kelly.
They have one turnover in the game when it looked like they might be able to go ahead and score some points. On first down, the handoff goes to John Kelly, gets a block around the corner. Penalty flag goes down as Kelly gets to a
first down.
The ball is up around the 23, and they've got to go out near the 47 to get their first down. Steve Taylor on a straight drop goes down the middle with it, and it is incomplete. No official response to it. It's second down and about 24. Ball is given off to the fullback, Micah Hyland, number 48. Where'd you learn that? You're from Maryland. You don't talk like that up there. Third down and 24 now. Jones, 55, jumps into the crack. Now he drops off. Taylor goes back to throw. No pressure on him. The pass is away. The pass is almost intercepted. Mayhew, number 32, was the man that had the best chance. Deion Sanders, the deep man, number 2 for Florida State. Kick is away, kind of slides off the side of his foot. Sanders fields it at the 43.
and wiggles around for a while, finally knocked down at the 44. That's a 30. Williams remains the fullback. Well, that's a greeting for Keith Ross, isn't it? Ball was stuck in his tummy just about the time Chris Buckman, great athlete, hasn't seen the ball tonight. Might drag him down the middle. Back goes Chip Ferguson. They had him wide open. They throw instead to the fullback, Dane Williams, and Williams running for the marker. I think they mark him just short of it. And then they have Pat Carter. Fullback goes inside with it, trying for the first down. Dane Williams, a 225-pounder. And it just depends on Williams to left foot or right for blocking. Pitch it to Ross. Ross on a sweep didn't make it. He did not make it. The entire defensive flow to the left side. Broderick, Thomas, and Chris Buckman coming over there. Thomas, a sophomore. Buckman, of course, the senior.
They've started the play in tonight's game.
6 out of 33. Leading Florida State's total offense because the FSU's total right now is only 31 yards. So Taylor will pull the trigger. Nebraska's loaded up on the right side, and he goes that way. And his pass zinged. Incomplete is Vaughn Shepherd, the junior out of St. Paul, Minnesota. The wing back fell down. All right. Right-handed ball club most of the time. They break the play and come to the left side. The wing middle. When you see that wing back come, there is daylight down the middle. No question about it. Taylor rolls it right. Pulls it down and takes off with it. Now he throws it incomplete just as he gets to the sideline.
All right, George, Keith, back to you. That's a speedy Husker.
Indeed he is. A little drop pass out in the flat is dropped by the fullback, Dane Williams. On second down and 10, Chip Ferguson from the goal line throws the swing pass out. Loss on the play as Keith Ross brings it up to about the 9, and he was lucky to get
third
that down
far.
And 12 from the 9. Chip Ferguson hands the ball to Keith Ross. Ross isn't going anywhere. Huskers really punishing. They really jumped him that time, trying to knock him loose.
Very average
at 43 last year. They need a big one here. He gets some pressure, but he gets it out and puts it way up into the night sky, all the way back to the Nebraska 49. And Brinson is going to lose yards as he retreats. And Nebraska now settling into a defensive struggle after the Seminoles took the opening kickoff and put it in the end zone. It's Keith Jones and Ken Kalin in the I formation behind Steve Taylor for the Huskers. Looks to throw it. Gets it off to the sideline. Rob Spitzler is over there. Second down and out. Power I formation. Taylor drops back to throw the ball. Going down the middle with it. He's got a man open, and it's overthrown. Todd Milliken, the tight end. He was two strides.
Disagree with you.
And home. Third down and 10. Taylor again sets up, gets pressure, runs out of it. Got a lot of daylight. Deion Sanders gets in at the 20-yard line. 34-yard run.
For young Buffalo, Brandon quickly felt the pressure and got out of there.
First down, Nebraska, just short of the Florida State 20. Ball is kept by the quarterback, Taylor. He breaks the loose. He scores. Welcome to the Steve Taylor Show. In for the extra point, Dale Klein. Out of Blakeman's hole. It is up. And it is good. Florida State, 220-pounder. Tanner Holloman's in at fullback. Chip Ferguson slips a little as he sets the pass, but delivers it, and it's complete to Pat Carter, is tight end. Ferguson gives to Sammy Smith, and Smith will have the first down. Smith, who has had Movement in the backfield for Florida State. Chip Ferguson breaks out of the pack and runs for about 7 or 8 yards.
But I think they're going to get a penalty
from the 34. As they're up, lose the 5 yards from the 39, and Ferguson shoots it down the middle. And
second down and 13.
Gainer had his seminal. Quick pop goes to Tanner Holloman, the fullback, 205-pounder. David Palmer and Dane Williams
at
Arizona, at least from the angle we can see. And Florida State retains the ball just over the 40, which third down and call it 9. Chip Ferguson back. Heats off. Down he goes. Danny Noonan. 6'4", 280 pounds, and he is fullback.
That caused a little anxiety.
6-13 to play in the first half. Huskers have it, and Steve Taylor goes down the line with it. Keeps it. And moves it up to the 45-yard Huskers. 7-7 ball game. Pitch to Keith Jones. Daylight on the right side. First down at midfield. Midfield first down Huskers. Taylor gives it to Jones. Some thunder and lightning on the
right side.
Brinson comes wide to the bottom of your picture. Jason gambles up the top. Taylor spins around, wings it out to Brinson. He's out there by himself, and a lot of white shirts chasing him, and they bring him down at the 40. Martin May gets third down and about a foot. And Taylor, the quarterback, keeps it over the right side, and you have the first down.
A good one.
Keith Jones goes in motion. Now he comes back the other way.
what is he doing?
Warming up, I guess. Ball goes to Jones over the right side. He picks up about 3 yards. Florida State.
Warming up.
Ridden off to the fullback. Caleb is rolled up.
Well, back in Bill Peterson's day, they used to score a lot of points.
Jim Hammond and those guys, they really roll them up. You got a reverse. And trapped is Vaughn Shepherd behind the line of scrimmage, and a penalty flag goes down. Back at the 45, as Shepherd goes down, Thomas Harp has Preston trying to untie it. Steve Taylor gives the wing back, the old wing back counter coming this way, and Brinson is dropped. Short of the line.
Second down and 12. The ball is back near the 24.
Steve Taylor coming around, turns a corner, butts heads in there at the line of scrimmage, and down he will go. He was butting heads with Fred Jones, and I'll guarantee you that Steve Taylor, even at 195 pounds, is going to lose that head butting contest because Jones weighs 240 pounds and he is dead to
front.
Quick trap in the middle. Goes Ken Kalen, busts his way down to about the 16-yard line. Lakeman gets it down. Klein hits it. Crowd says it's good, and so do the men in the sweatshirt. And Nebraska goes for the lead. For the base pass. So let's see what Chip Ferguson can do. 10-7, Nebraska leads. Ball goes to Sammy Smith. Smith still got it. Look out! Great speed. Gets a block. One man. Touchdown. Great run by Sammy Smith. Herb Gainer, the little wide receiver. Not so little. The wide receiver split in. And Vaughn Shepherd. And it's a short kick again. Shepherd comes up, lets it bounce, hits in a puddle of water, doesn't go anywhere, picks it up, wiggles its way up the sidelines, and goes out of bounds at about the 24-yard line. Fullback and I-back position. Jones, the I-back, has the ball, wedges over the right side, and gets out to about the 26, close to the 27. First quarter stats changing now to second quarter or halftime stats.
See, look at that time of possession down the bottom there for Nebraska, and they only got 10 points out of it. But out of the 177 total yards, as we said, 120 of those on just 3 plays.
From the 27, it's second down and 7 for the Cornhuskers. Steve Taylor, who's had a big night at quarterback, lobs the pass out to Dana Brinson, and Brinson is buried and didn't get something going here. Brett Jones jumps up into the middle of the gap, now drops out. Taylor takes the ball to Jones, keeps it, throws downfield, passes incomplete, and the rest of the third time. 34 and 38 is 2 previous kicks. Just beginning the second half of play. A little pressure on him this time, but gets a good kick out of there. Sanders indicates fair catch and then runs past the ball as it moves away.
All right, Keith, if you don't mind, I'm going to stay here and watch the game for a while.
I don't blame you. Penalty flags are down. Little short lob thrown out by Chip Ferguson to Sammy Smith, and Smith is shaking off tacklers and finally taken out of bounds.
His own life, and Brad now talks of it openly and says that it motivates him. And he has graduated already, Keith, from the University of Nebraska in 4 years.
For Florida State, as Chip Ferguson gets his pass away, it might be intercepted. Nope. Brian Davis was the man who had a shot at it, but Brian Davis
is falling again.
Lewis Berry for the punt. That's more like it for Berry. That looks like Lewis Berry. That is a howitzer fielded back on the 10-yard line by Dana Brinson, but he's off to the races. Fumbles the ball. Florida State recovers at the Nebraska 35. Fake to Sammy Smith. Chip Ferguson keeps it. And he's thrown out of bounds by Tony Holloway. The defensive end stays on top of the picture. Holloman bottom of the picture on third down and a long five. Ferguson looks to throw. Goes down the middle. Pat Carter. Carter fighting to get to the marker. And I think he might have made it. It'll be. There's your movement right there. Three of them going too soon. Derek Smith brings the kicking tee onto the field now. And they put the tee down at the 37. It'll be a 47-yarder. His longest is 54. So this is within his range. Kick is away. Good. 47-yard field goal. The ball hung on and went just inside the
second
right
down and
right.
Seven from the 40.
Steve Taylor down the line on the option. Outside it goes to Jones. Gets a block from the lead man, the fullback. Gets the first down as he turns the corner at down the 49. Carter to Jones. Oh, look at him weave his way through there, and he's got another first down. Just inside the Florida State 40. Brinson goes in motion for Nebraska. Taylor coming on the option. Keeps it. Fullback and runs into the... Taylor back to throw. Little flip out here to Kelly. Has a man in front of him. Puts his helmet down and goes straight ahead, trying to get all he can get out of it.
And he made
Dan
a pay.
Parker, third down and two. Ooh. Oh, that is a major league hit. Seminoles are all punched right in tight. Keith Jones is back. Taylor's got the ball. Gets around the corner. And almost broken. He's got the first down at the 21. Brett Jones, Florida State 21. Ball goes to Keith Jones. Steps over the line of scrimmage and goes to the 15. Right now, Taylor's looking at third down and eight. Back to throw. Lobs it away, and the pass is incomplete, and you get a flag on it. Pass thrown toward Rod Smith, Eric Williams.
So it goes down at that point where it is first down and goal for Nebraska at the Florida State 6.
So the Seminoles' mistake now. And Nebraska's knocking on the front door. Taylor down the line on the option. Keeps it. Anyway, number 17, Cleo Miller, almost got in there and blocked that thing. Taylor keeps it. And we'll pick out 64 yards.
So you're mixing their plays well.
Taylor goes outside to Keith Jones. He gets a little bit of a corner and turns it. There'll be 2 yards short of the first half. Goes to Jones again, and a big hole over the right side for the first half.
175, he's almost 200 now.
Second down is 10 as he literally got no gain out of it. Should be a near penalty flag. Ball was thrown to Ron Smith. Taylor still got it.
Got a man.
Touchdown. Todd Milliken. First down. And they're behind by 7. Chip Ferguson pitches to Sammy Smith. And Smith is drilled and driven back. Number 19, Brian Siebler, and number 35, Kevin Person, doing the job on him. Ferguson takes it to Smith. And goes down. He was looking down the field. Every white. Having a little trouble in the second half, getting something going. Ferguson looking, gets his pass away to the sidelines, and maybe he couldn't get his footing down for that sharper cut. Third quarter stats.
This is interesting. You can see the rushing yardage and how it has really gone now heavily in the favor of Nebraska. But now let's go down to the total yards. This, the 175 yards, total yards gained by Florida State, is 2 less than they had at halftime. So they lost 2 in the third quarter.
Well, that's the first down they've had in the second half. Second down. Short 5. Smith coming this way. Drilled backwards. Losing a yard on the play. Mark Munford and Tony Holloway. Defensively for Nebraska, numbers 91 and 41.
Bobby Bowden is one of the most innovative coaches, I think, in college football, and I just have that feeling that he's going to come up with a little something special soon.
A good time. Well, third down might be at least 5 from the 49, trailing by 7 in the fourth quarter. Ferguson runs away from Munford, but he cannot run away from Danny Noonan. He had Micah Heibel in the backfield. Heibel, the fullback, Geller, the eye back. Inside it goes to Heibel. And the junior from Lincoln picks up. Carter gets tangled up, but then untangles and breaks loose. Steve Taylor it is, and he moves to the.
Because with it now, they also bring in flexibility. There was that.
Well, Boyd Epley runs the program here in Nebraska, and he's got a catalog on everybody who's been through here. He can tell you how high they jumped when they came and how high they jumped when they left.
I jump as high as Danny Newman told me to.
Goes to the eye back Kelly, and John Kelly knocked off.
Same hole. That's a tough track.
Taylor gets it away, and he's got a man over there, Rob Schnitzler, and the senior from Battle Creek. Well, they'll take the first down. Heibel gets the ball, and
somebody
the body
like that belongs to the National Honor Society.
Taylor is caught, and hanging on is 78 Eric Hayes. Steve Taylor drops the throw. Lets it go down the sidelines. Passes complete to Vaughn Shepherd, and touchdown. Victor Floyd is into the game, first time since the first possession at tailback. Chip Ferguson throws. That's a quarterback sack by number 99, Neil Smith, the junior from Third down and about 20. Ferguson's got a man out here. Floyd, the tailback, and he's out of bounds at the 35. Floyd. He ran over the stack and picked up 6 yards. Good run by Floyd. That's Demare in motion. Handed inside to the fullback, Dane Williams. Faked it to Sammy Smith, and Brad Tyrer ate him up.
In tonight's opening game.
First down, Huskers, from the 31. Taylor going down the line, gives the ball away to the fullback, Micah Heibel. Second down and 6. Taylor still got this one. And Steve Taylor has a first down at the 45. Martin Mayhew. Running ball to a fine quarterback. So I think that'll be a heck of a football game. It'll be fun to watch Lou Holtz see what he's done at Notre Dame. This is John Kelly. And Kelly rambles for a first down for Nebraska. Nebraska has come roaring back to dominate the ball game in the second half. John Kelly takes a hard hit from Greg Newell to turn Nebraska's way. And that stat right there will tell you much about what has happened on the field. Florida State in the second half is minus 2 yards. And now the Nebraska offensive front,
guys, they big feet, they can grow into them.
Steve Taylor, who's had a huge night, gets his pass away. Pass is complete to Willie Griffin. And it's first down, Cornhuskers, down around the Florida State 20. There's the story of the second half, and that's exactly why the Nebraska Cornhuskers have run off 21, 20-yard line of Florida State. Taylor stays in there at quarterback. Takes the handoff. Oh, he gave it away. And on second and 7, Taylor keeps it and slips inside to the 14.
Al has going the game away. Changed over 91 years.
Yeah. He's had a lot of fun being a Nebraska fan. Back goes Taylor to throw. Gets it away. Under pressure. He was looking at a big linebacker right in the eye, coming whistling at him, and he delivered the pass on a line to Willie Griffin.
All week because of the NCAA penalty.
Appealed and stay granted for this game. Kick is up by Klein. Into the net. Good. And a decision will be made on their appeal next week. Next Tuesday. 34-17.
Thomas, we're going to season a freshman a little bit right here and let him kick off in a ball game.
They have control with very little time left to play. Hangs it up there for Keith Ross at the 11. And Ross is down at 8. And back goes Ferguson to throw again. To the sidelines, and it's incomplete. No good. Rain's coming down again. It figures everybody's trying to get to their car and go home now as time is just about run out. And here is another sack of Chip Ferguson by Neil Smith. That's his second sack of the night and the 7th risky business of defense. Blakeman keeps on the option play and gets the clock rolling. And whistles now will stop it at about 9 seconds or so. No, they didn't stop it. I thought for a moment they were going to whistle the clock dead. Florida State's second half offense, minus 1 yard. Only 2 first downs and both by penalty, and the ball game is over. The Nebraska Cornhuskers open with an impressive 34-17 victory over the Florida State Seminoles. So it looks like it's going to be another year in the Big 8, Nebraska and Oklahoma.